Hello, and welcome to another episode of 5 Minutes with Franza. I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza. In this episode, we're going to be covering range names using Excel 2010. It works the same for 2007 and actually 2003 as well, just the menu structure is slightly different, but the concepts apply. I'll also give you a little bit of information on the positives and negatives of using range names. Okay, so let's get started. So, if we want to be able to define a range name, what we do is we highlight the range that we want, and then we click over here and we give it a name. In this case, I'm going to call it name. So now I've defined this range, A2 through A8, to be called name. Let's see if it works. I'm going to use the count A, and I'm going to say name. Notice how it went blue, and it also highlighted cells A2 through A8. And there you go. I have 7 students in my class, Ralph through Piggy, and therefore it worked. So let's try another way. Let's say I want to get the average for quiz 1. Well, I highlight the range that I want, and now I want to give it a name. I could simply go here and I could type quiz 1, or I can come over to formulas, define a name, and look what it did. It says, You're using a column. Because you're defining a column, it goes to directly above it and it grabs the label. In this case, quiz 1. Also note, there's an underscore here, quiz underscore 1. You cannot have spaces in range names. That's a bad thing. So there you go. So now I've just defined quiz 1. Let's see if it worked. I'm going to say the average for quiz, helps if you can spell, 1. And there you go. The quiz average is an 86. I could also do it this way. I could say, all right, I want to have an average for each student. So I highlight across, and I want this to be the average for, I want this to be the grades that Jack received, not the average, just the grades. So I highlight across the range, B3 to D3, come to define name, and look, it automatically now, because I went across the row, it looked to the label to the left, and it grabbed Jack. And I say, okay. And I can do it again. So you can see, it's very easy to quickly create range names. Now, here's where range names can be bad. Okay, so here I would say this equals the average for Jack. Right, and there we go, and that works. But let's try something. Okay, what would happen if we made a mistake, right? In that case, I called this Eric. Now, when I come over here and I do the average for Eric, right? See, if you're trying to troubleshoot this, you're going to look and say, wait a minute, something doesn't make sense. 84, 85, 86, yet his average is 100. But right here, it says the average for Eric. So obviously, it has to be Eric. Well, once you click on Eric, you'll see that it's actually Piggy. But let's do something else. There's another way that you can determine this. Under formulas, you'll see name manager. The name manager gives you all of the range names, the values for those for that range, and the reference, the cells that it refers to. So in this case, I see Eric, 100, 100, 100. Ah, those are Piggy's grades. Also right here, it says B8 through D8. So that's the wrong one. So I would click here and I would say delete. Are you sure? Yes, I'm sure. Now look what happened. You see it says pound name question mark. This is Excel's way of saying, huh? I don't understand what you're talking about because I've used a range which is not defined. Okay? So when you get that, it usually means you have misspelling. So be careful. When you use range names, they can be very convenient because I now know that this is the average for Jack, but it makes some assumptions come into play. And you know what happens once you assume. Well, there you have it. Those are range names in a nutshell. I hope you found this episode of 5 Minutes with Franza useful. Once again, I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza, and thank you for watching.